For number six, a horizontal power line carries a current of 4,230 amps from south to north. Earth's magnetic field is 63.6 microteslas and is directed towards the north and is inclined downwards at 64.0 degrees to the horizontal. We're asked to find the magnitude first. So we're going to write down everything that we have. We have a current that is 4,230 amps, and this goes from south to north. If we draw a compass right here, we have north, east, south, and west. Our magnetic field is directed towards the north and is inclined downwards. So if it's directed up north but inclined downwards, it'll be at 64 degrees. To find the magnitude, we need to find the force. So we're gonna have to use a formula for force, and it is the current times L times B times the sine of our angle. We can plug in our values. We have our current, that's 4,230 amps. We have our L, which we were given right here, 99 meters. And we could write that down with one of the values that we were given. So the length is 99 meters, and we plug that into our equation here. And we are multiplying this by sine of 64 degrees. We can't forget about our B, which is the magnetic field. So if we scoot our sine over, we can put in the magnetic field, which is 63.6 microteslas, and we need to convert that to teslas. So we have 63.6 times 10 to the negative 6 teslas. After we plug all this into our calculator, we are going to get that our F, or our magnitude, is approximately 24 newtons, and that is for A. For part B, we are asked to find the direction of the magnetic force on 99 meters of the line due to Earth's field. For this, we can look at this graph here and make it a little bit more 3D. We're going to have our original graph like this, or the y-axis like this, and we're going to have our north and our south values. However, our west and east values are going to be drawn at a slight angle like this. And we can draw a line through the center just to show that it is 3D. Now, Earth's magnetic field is directed towards the north. So originally, it's going to be pointed up here. This is what our first information is telling us. And our next is that it's inclined downward to the horizontal. This is our horizontal line right here. So if it's inclined 64 degrees, this angle is going to turn like this. So basically, we can see that the incline, or the magnetic field, is going to be into the page. X means that it is going into the page. And since it's going into the page, if we look at our 2D graph, the north, east, south, and west, we are going to see that basically our angle is going to be going up and then down into the page, kind of like this. If we use our right hand rule, we can see that our fingers are going to be curling into the page, just like they are here. If we draw our right hand like this, we can see that our fingers are going to be curling into the page, curling in like this. What this means is that our thumb is going to be pointed this way. And if our thumb is pointed that way, like this, that means it's going to be pointed in the west direction. So for part B, the direction is going to be to the west.